So I need to request all the speakers to be behind this podium so we can introduce one after another. We only have 2 minutes for each speaker, and then we will have a special speaker to announce our CFA action plan moving forward. So please, all the speakers, Canadian Families Alliance action plan. Thank you. All the speakers at the back of this podium, please join us here. And we are also asking Mr. Nadeem Qureshi to meet Mr. Khalid Mahmood as soon as possible. Thank you. We'll be starting soon. So we'll start our speeches with a few more reminders. Once again, thank you so much for coming here on this Sunday afternoon, and we say no together. We have an amazing lineup of speakers. Every speaker will speak for 2 minutes. The code of conduct involves no bashing, any political bashing, no explicit language because we have kids in the audience. Please avoid using explicit language and the words. And we're not here to bash against any political party or any community. So there should not be any anti-gay or anti-religion language. Our speakers, again, will be talking about several things, including curriculum and all the action plans we're talking about on behalf of Canadian Families Alliance. Canadian Families Alliance was formed that accompanies all major parents group in Ontario, and we are coming together to speak up against this injustice and against this indoctrination of our children. We are coming together to speak for all of us. We are coming together to denounce the cheap, deceptive politics, and we are coming together to raise our voice and continue raising our voice against unfair political tactics. And our marshals are working really hard to guide us, to support us, to protect our safety, especially the safety of our children. So my request for the parents and everybody in the audience to please follow our marshals. Please listen to their instructions carefully and follow their advice. We will be marching after the speeches, and we want to make sure the safety of everybody in attendance. Please make sure that you give way to media personnel to come forward here to capture our speeches and everything that we are doing today. We will be announcing our Canadian Families Alliance Action Plan, and we want our media personnel to capture that properly. Please make room for them. And please avoid any messes or leaving any garbage. We are parents. We're coming here to set a precedent of solidarity, integrity, and values. You want to make sure to leave just like that, no mask. We need to show our Canadian values here. We are here as Canadian parents, right? We are here together, and we follow each other's lead to show our Canadian values. And please do avoid any confrontation with any of the groups if they show up and they're opposing our view or proposition. Please avoid any confrontation. Please avoid any confrontation and responding to them. Let our marshals deal with them and stay in the grounds, on the grassy land, and follow the leads of our marshals. One more thing to remember, we have washrooms on site for families, especially with young children. Everybody is more than welcome to attend here. The washrooms are available here. You're more than welcome to use them. But again, remember the Canadian values. We care about each other. We share with cleanliness. So remember that. Once again, in the name of God, my name is Farina Siddiqui. I am representing Coalition of Concerned Parents, and we are part of Canadian Families Alliance, coming together. I'm pleased to announce our first speaker, Maggie Amin, who is from the Islamic Cultural Association of Ontario. Maggie Amin.
Thank you. Yeah.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
How are you?
Good.
Great day today, right?
Yeah.
Right in front of Kathleen Wynn's office, right?
Yeah.
Kathleen Wynn has turned our schools into an unsafe place for our children.
Yes!
A place where the sexuality of our children is going to be questioned outside their homes.
Yes!
A place where transgenderism will be promoted on our children. A place where gender fluidity is promoted. Our children will be encouraged to challenge the wisdom of their parents. If you want that, stay in public schools. I don't.
No!
No! No!
Premier Wynn is threatening the stability of our family union. We are not homophobic. We live side by side by the LGBT. But how is it fair that such a minority, in order to have or gain acceptance and affirmation from the society, that we, our children, this generation is indoctrinated into their lifestyle? How is that fair?
No!
She is creating a division between us and the LGBT. Since she has presumed office, Canada has been in turmoil.
Right.
Ontario has been in turmoil. She's legislating and not negotiating. It's orders and rules upon us. Canada has never witnessed such dictatorship. Justin Trudeau is supporting her. She has silenced teachers. She has silenced MPPs. She has silenced trustees. Well, Mr. Trudeau, our children are not a provincial issue. Our children and their well-being and their safety is from now on a federal issue.
Yeah.
It's a federal issue, yeah. A nationwide issue. And you will no longer get our support come October in the federal elections.
No!
No more liberals!
No more liberals!
No more liberals!
No more liberals!
I have badges today for everybody. I have a badge, a pink badge that says, I'm a girl, don't confuse me. And I have a blue badge saying, I'm a boy, don't confuse me. I also have a form. If you have an organization or a parent group and you wish to join Canadian Families Alliance, please come to me right there and I'll get your names and emails and we will love for you to join us. Thank you very much.
No more letters! No more letters! No more letters! No more letters!
Great. One more reminder, please, parents, if you can come in front of us. We really want to see all your lovely faces in front of us. Please leave this area. Please empty this area. We truly appreciate your cooperation and understanding. Please follow the leads of our marshals. Stay at the front of this podium. Nobody beside this podium and behind this podium. Thank you so much. I appreciate cooperation. Please join us here. We'd love to see your lovely faces chanting with us. And with this, I would like to invite our next speaker, Sam Sotropoulos from My Child, My Choice!
Hello everyone.
Hi, Omar.
My Child.
My Choice!
My Child.
My Choice!
My Child.
My Choice!
In my term as a Toronto District School Board Trustee, I never had parents come to me and ask me for their children to learn more about sex. Not once. They came to me, they asked me for mathematics, they asked me for science, they asked me for English, they asked me for writing, they asked me for reading, they never asked me for masturbation. That never happened. And in the 28 schools that were under my purview, there was not a single transgender, whatever you want to call them, student, not one. And throughout my tenure at the TESB, I never once ran across a single transgender student. Surprise? Not really. Now, ladies and gentlemen, what we're doing here today is important.
Yes.
It is important on many levels. I'm going to tell you, in the best way that I can, a little story which will help to explain how we're going to move forward from this day.
Yes.
This is an old story. It's been told for thousands of years, and some of you will recognize it. A long time ago, in a town much like ours, there was a family and a community of mice, many of them, and they were living together wonderfully with the human beings because they were stealing the cheese and eating to their heart's content from the garbage and the leftovers of the human community in which they lived. And then one day, a cat was introduced into the neighborhood. And suddenly the party stopped. No more frolicking for the families of the mice. No more running around. No more playing in the fields. No more night raids into the garbage because they were all afraid of the cat. And then one day they decided to hold a meeting. A committee, a rally, a demonstration of sorts, kind of like what we're doing here or have been doing over the last 6 months. They decided to hold a meeting to see what they were going to do to get their lives back, much like we are doing. And at that point, they discussed many different plans. And suddenly, one little small mouse came up and said, "I have a plan, ladies and gentlemen." And they said, "What is your plan?" And then he said, "It's very simple. When the cat comes around, we'll put a bell around its neck. And that way, the bell will ring whenever the cat approaches. And we will know. And we will be able to run away and keep our children safe." Well, of course, the next question that was asked at the meeting was, "Great idea. Who's going to hang the bell around the cat?" Well, at that point, all the mice ran away. We're not going to run away.
No!
That was the first and last mouse committee that's been ever held on the planet. Our fight is not going to end after this rally or after our meeting. Our fight will continue for 3 years if necessary. Because
we will fight on Team Death.
We will not forgive, and we will punish the politicians. Don't ask what your neighbor is doing about this. Ask what you are doing about this. Don't be like the mice.
No.
Do not be like the mice.
No.
Each and every one of us must take action, whatever that action may be. Confronting an activist teacher in front of your children, if necessary. Yes, do it. Do not be afraid.
Yes.
If it takes calling the police because a teacher told your child to go home and try masturbation, do it. Do not hesitate. If it takes going on a weekly basis to your MPP's office and making them understand that their job hangs in the balance, do it. Speak to your neighbors, speak to your friends, punish liberals and progressives everywhere.
No more levelers!
Inappropriate, and no one asked us. My child!
My choice!
My child!
My choice!
My child!
My choice!
Do not be mice.
Yeah. Yeah. We will fight on Team Death!
Thank you everyone, just a reminder, please move back a little bit.
Nobody can see from the back. Speakers cannot be seen.
Mami, ¿dónde estás?
For that visit, we have only 6 inches.
Thank you.
People can see from the back.
Our next speaker is Mr. Ahmed Hamoud, and he's from GTA Parents Association.
Mr. Hamoud.
Greetings, parents of Ontario. Greetings, the grandparents of Ontario. Greetings, the children of Ontario. Greetings, the supporters of Ontario. I salute you all for the courage and the commitment that you show to protect your kids' innocence. You are a shield protecting your children and their future from Kathleen Wayne and Bin Laden grand design to indoctrinate them with sex ideology at this tender age. It's a plan to hijack your sexually whole rights to bring your children according to your values and religious belief. What do we say to this plan?
No!
What do we say to this plan?
No!
What's promoted as a sex education is in reality is indoctrination. Not dissimilar to what used to happen in communist Soviet Union when kids were taken away, you know, from parents and indoctrinated with Marxism, Leninism. But what the liberals and Kathleen Wayne is doing, they are indoctrinating our children with sex ideology based on voodoo science. What do we say to that?
No!
We say no!
No!
Let us stay united and continue this fight. It's not a fight for one or two community children. It's a fight for all Ontario children. We are one community, we are one society. Our kids, they play with each other, they interact, you know, with each other, they socialize with each other. So this is an Ontario parent fight. Kathleen Wayne is hoping and hoping upon hope that we disappear. We say to her, we are here to stay, we are here to stay, we are here to stay. Finally, we have what we want to say to Kathleen Wayne. We don't want your curriculum. Take it back, take it back. Take it back, take it back.
Take it back, take it back.
Take it back, take it back.
Take it back, take it back.
And thank you very much.
Thank you, Ahmed Hamoud. And again, a reminder to our wonderful, passionate speakers that the time is for 2 minutes each. We have a great lineup. We need to make sure that we are following the timelines. Great. And we say?
No!
We say?
No!
Okay. So our next speaker is Samir Ahmed from the Scarborough Parents Association. And that will follow with our beautiful parent, Gada Malik, with her wonderful, wonderful, passionate chanting. So stay tuned.
Thank you very much. And dear parents, today I'm standing in front of you to address this very important issue with the fact all of our families. A strong that is being created by the very people who have elected this public office by our vote and who had promised prosperity for all of our entire families. My question to all of you Is this what we want from our children in this beautiful country of ours?
No!
Is this what this government will give us back in return for our vote and putting our faith in their goodness?
No!
My fellow parents, our children are our biggest assets. Our purpose of